return to a no call. Clear and conclusive. And Gibson legally deflected the basketball. Any contact after the legal deflection is marginal incidental. In the immediate aftermath of the whistle, the ball was loose. Therefore, there'd be a jump ball semicircle between any two opponents. So we're in the game at the time, and the shot clock will be reset to 24. Challenge is successful. Washington gets their timeout back.
Well, our apologies to Wes Hartzell Jr., but listen, we're not being a homer here. I strongly disagree with that call.
Wow, that's a huge, huge turn of events. Incredibly successful for Washington. I mean, negating those three free throws.
We will give you another look at it as soon as we can get to it. That's a huge challenge. It worked out well for Wes Hartzell Jr. A one-point lead for the Wizards. Their ball at 2:18 to play. In OT. Beal. Stripped by Caleb Martin. He took it away. Martin will wait for help. Well, he just refused to back down. Refused to give in to the extraordinary circumstances working against them. Lowry. Stutter-stepping on Kispert. With 8 on the shot clock. 8 down by 1. 1:52 left. The Lowry 3. Short. Rebound to Kuzma. Pressure back on the Heat defense. Heater 11 for 40 from 3. That's just under 28%. Inside Beal. He lost it out of bounds. They say last touch by Miami. Here's another look at the Orlando Robinson shot.
They're saying there was a deflection first. You know, Coach Bode's going to challenge on this end right now, this deflection that went off the Wizards, he believes.
Tell. It was Tyler Mirkovich, the rookie official underneath, that gave it a look.
Certainly, defense there by Robinson, it looks like he hit the ball and perhaps it went off Beal's left knee. Let's see if we can get another angle or a better look. That angle right there looks positive for Miami, like it went off Beal's hand.
You know, we've seen 3 or 4 replays, and still hard to draw a conclusion on. Three of those threes he made tied the game at 104 to force overtime with 15 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Hey, Eric, let me clean something up there. Each team has two timeouts left. I misread the scoreboard there.
42 seconds left. The Heat trailing by a point. Highsmith, baseline drive on Porzingis. Blocking foul on Kristaps Porzingis. Fifth foul on Porzingis. 36 seconds left in the overtime.
Quick catch and go move by Haywood Highsmith on that baseline. Porzingis caught out of position here. Nice ball reversal by Orlando Robinson as he catches it there in the mid-court area to go opposite. That's where the defense can really be shifted.
Side out of bounds for the Heat. 14 seconds on the shot clock. 35 seconds left in overtime. Highsmith fakes the three. Finds Robinson, and he bobbled the ball out of bounds.
Close quarters. Right idea. Just hard to execute there inside.
Wow. Painful turn. 25 seconds left. Shot clock at 18. A 5-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Again, they're on their feet here in D.C. This is Beal. Four to shoot. In the Taj Gibson. He missed it. Rebound of Strews. 2 seconds left. Timeout Heat with 2.8 seconds left. Taj Gibson, who's only taken two shots tonight, somehow the ball got to his hands on the Wizards' last possession. That's something that will not go over well with Wes Unseld Jr. when they look at that film. And now they may put some time back on the clock.
The big conversation here is whether the timeout came before the dribble or not, because the Heat won't be able to advance the ball to the front court. Coach Spo called timeout. If you look on the top of your screen, before Max dribbled it, and he's arguing with the official there, and I think they're going to give it to him because they put the ball into the front court right now. So otherwise, it would have to be a dribble. It would have to be where the ball was dribbled, side out in the backcourt. So he told the official before the miss, I want an immediate timeout on a rebound. And the officials appear to be honoring that. So the 2.8 seconds will be in the front court. So he'd have a much, much better opportunity.
And Taj Gibson got a great look. You can't question that. But only his second shot of the game. And you see Spo circled. He was signaling to Kevin Scott for the timeout. Well, the Heat will get it at half court, we assume, with 2.8 left. John, what do you run when you need a score for a win?
Well, you want to get it to Lowry, but the Heat, to me, are just continuing to be backing up instead of going downhill. They don't need a three here. They're trailing by one. Get something going towards the rim. At least maybe a pull-up jump shot or a runner, maybe a foul you can draw. If you have an open three, take it, but don't be taking a fadeaway three in this position if you don't have to. 2.8 seconds isn't a lot. Watch Lowry with a quick pass back to him on the move to do something.
This amazing game is about to be decided. Porzingis at 7'3" will harass the inbounds pass. Kyle looking and looking. Calls another timeout. Nobody was open. And that's great strategy by the Wizards to put their 7'3" inch center to guard the throw-in.
He covers a lot of ground. Hard to see.